groups and FITs. So we have a huge list of corporate groups of team size starting from 20 to 200 to 400 to 600. So we have operated all these kind of groups in series as well as in one go, depending upon the country and the airline connections available. So that is the reason we have a huge list of satisfied customer base, and that is our main strength, which helps the organization to develop exciting supply chain in the market. To explore constant possibilities of tourism in Central Asian countries and make a trimmed inventory of product offering true value to the customer is the main philosophy. By positioning us various junctures in the tourism value chain in the course of collaboration, Duke achieved a leverage position to offer customers best bargain on our travel products and services in Central Asia. So this was some small information about Duke. So this is about the company. Like we have, I will share you our global presence. So we have our head office in New Delhi. We have our offices in Almaty, Bishkek, Tashkent, Yerevan, Tbilisi, Kyiv, Moscow, Baku. We have offices in Mumbai and Dubai. This is very important for you. These are the local sales contact. These are the name and contact detail of our colleagues who are fully dedicated for travel agents, like connecting travel agents with Duke International. So whenever there's any inquiry regarding Central Asia, you can contact these people irrespective of your state or the region. So like from Mumbai, we have Abhishek Patil and Mr. Rahul Chaudhary. From Chennai, we have Madhusudan. We have Sayed from Hyderabad. We have Mr. Hitesh Jani from Ahmedabad, Rustic from Kolkata, and Shwetangi from Delhi NCR. So you need to have information that these are the contact details which you can always use and call them to help you related to any inquiry. Otherwise, website is there. Whenever you want any country information, we have all details. So this is about Duke. So if you see on the page of this screen, so we have information about everything. So for example, today we are going through Belarus training. So similarly, we have different countries training after this session. So we have every day, we have four sessions of 1 hour each. So I will just click on the Belarus, and this will take us to the information and the packages which we have uploaded on our website. So this is just for your reference. So if you feel like having a different itinerary as per your customer requirement, you can always come back and send us an email. So these are the basic details about the Belarus package. About the country, I will take you to the different website, which is dukeshare.com. So I request you to please log into dukeshare.com. I'll just give you 15-20 seconds. You can just type dukeshare.com and come on this page. So why I'm asking you to be on the same page? So that it will help you to recollect these websites next time, and also you should bookmark these websites like dukeinternational.com and dukeshare.com. You must bookmark these pages. So please log on to dukeshare.com. So if you see on this page, dukeinternational.com, we have information about the city of Belarus. We have information on different itineraries, inclusions. So I'm just click the check details. So we have a standard itinerary starting with the capital of Belarus, which is Minsk. So I will come to the destination in four or five minutes. So this is about the itinerary, standard itinerary we have uploaded, then the inclusions, then conditions. Then these are the visa requirements. So basically, it's like a normal documents, like 6 months bank statement, original invitation, a travel insurance photograph. We have the option of getting urgent visa as well as normal visa also within 5 working days. So getting visa for this country is very, very easy. So further detail, you can always contact us. We can send you a proper email. Otherwise, in a nutshell, the basic documents are bank statement, invitation, insurance, and photograph. So you don't need to give much documents. You have on arrival visa issue. You can take. You have option of group visas also. So this country is very, very friendly if it is when you come on visa. So now I will shift you to our product information. I will discuss about Belarus today. So now I'm on the website dukeshare.com. So you can see the Belarus, and I have just clicked the Belarus, and we'll just go through these details. The reason we are referring these websites because we will be upgrading these websites. We keep on upgrading these websites. So depending upon the new countries which we are introducing. So it is not only this list of countries. There are many more countries to be uploaded. So you can always refer these websites. So we will start with Minsk. So Minsk, its capital of Belarus, is a modern city dominated by monumental stainless architecture. Most of the architectural structure in the country was destroyed in World War II, and the city had to build and renew the city from scratch with the addition of wide street and stylish buildings. Today, it attracts more visitors than ever as it caters to the desires of travelers, be it budget, attractions, or hospitality. We have a chat box on the right side of this screen. So we have started getting questions also. So whenever you have any questions, we have team sitting to reply your questions. So please put on your questions. It will be replied with by our colleagues who are also part of this training. Minsk is a vibrant city which offers visitors its museum, theaters, and other historical and cultural attractions. So one of the most iconic and important landmarks of the city is Independence Avenue, a wide 1,500 kilometer long thoroughfare leading to a vast Independence Square. Looming over this iconic plaza are a massive KGB headquarters and the new Romansky Church of St. Simon and Helena, so also known as the Red Church. So as I told you, we are using DukeShare. So DukeShare is one stop to find the information on Belarus as well as other countries. It lists all the attractions, hotel, and other travel-related services. So we are just sharing the basic information about this country, which is important for us to know, to inform our customer, to educate our customer, to create interest in our customer so that they can decide to travel to this country as per if the interest suits them, depending upon the information which we give. So it is totally upon us how we educate the customer and how they respond. So depending on that, they will give you. Just 1 minute, sir. Now we'll go through the attractions of the Minsk. So basically, Belarus State Museum of the History of the Great Patriotic War. So it is a museum in celebration of the Great Patriotic War from the Nazi occupation. It was opened in 1944 and has over 24 exhibition halls. It showcases around 142,670 items in the museum. So the museum has its research team that digs into the history of the country. So if you can see the image, the weapons and the planes and the tanks which were used during the wars has been displayed. The image of the great warriors who led their life during the world wars can be seen there with brief history about them. Then we come to National Opera and Ballet Theater of Belarus. So this is one of the biggest theater in Europe, and it is almost 85 years old. So the theater has hosted over 20,000 performances over its 200 perimeter area. It is located in Minsk downtown, and its within easy reach. In 2015, the doors were open to visitors to go backstage and see the mystery behind the amazing performances. So this is the image of the opera and the ballet theater of Belarus. So it's really huge in size and multi-story. So there are multi-sitting layers, if you can see in the image. So Belarus has also some fun activities to offer for different traveler groups. So if your family willing to travel to this country, so they have few activities for themselves as well as for the kids. So it's a communal cultural and sports enterprise which has operating fitness centers and organizing many cultural events. It has many floors that caters to different type of sports and recreational activities such as beauty center, martial art hall, water area, thermal complex, and many more. Belarusian State Circus. So it is an old circus which started in 19th century and hosts many world famous artists such as Antoni Durov, Skipon, Siniseli, Ivan Zaykin, and many others. So it was destroyed in World War II, but reconstructed in 1946. So I'm not going much deep into the history of anything so that we can have a basic idea about this country. So whenever you want any extra detail, we are always there to share you. Otherwise, Google is also there. If you want any deep detailed information on these countries, you can take from the websites. Otherwise, if you can send us email or contact us through our business development team, we can send you a proper detail about this country. So it was destroyed in World War II, but reconstructed again in 1946. So there are two circuits operating in this country. So this is the image of the circuits. It's really huge in size and well maintained. This is a Patriot Shooting Gallery. It is a great place for indoor activity, and it's quite unique as it offers travelers a different kind of experience from most places. There are three shooting galleries where you can find a wide selection of weapons to use during the activity. It also helps instructing and advise you to how it is to be done. Okay, Republic Palace. The modern hospitable building is a theater and a performance center. Apart from this, it is also an important place where big decisions are announced in relation to summits, meetings, seminars, conferences, etc. It is located in the city center, one of the most popular attractions. Teleport. It is a visual entertainment park located in one of the country's largest shopping mall called the Green City. The park is over 1,400 square meter in area and holds a capacity of 120 people, but on major event it can be expanded to over 300 guests. It is an interesting place for entertainment filled with AR and audio and video technologies. The reason I'm taking a few seconds pause because we have some partners joining the meeting, so I just need to approve them. So in between, I'm taking small 5 to 7 seconds pause just to approve their participation. So we were at the teleport. Okay, now we come to Dino Park. So the city also has a Dino Park. It is an adventure park ideal for family and kids located in Minsk Zoo. So you and the kids get to discover full-size sounding and moving dino figures. So there are many kind of event which takes place in the park, especially birthday parties for the kids and etc. Now we come to the few common things which you will find in most of the countries of Europe. So churches and cathedrals. So this is Holy Spirit Cathedral, if you see. It is one of the most important churches in Minsk, and it's been preserved for many centuries. The church has a unique facade, and it's visited through many pilgrim and religious tour. The cathedral was once a Catholic church, then went on to Orthodoxy. So this is a beautiful image of this church. It's really huge in the size. If you see the fifth image, you can imagine the size of this. Now we come to the Church of Saint Simon and Helena. So this is a great legendary story behind the church. Therefore, the local love it. It was made on the order of a royal family between 1908 to 1910. There are two small towers and a bronze statue in front of the church, which adds beauty to the church. Then Church of All Saints. So we have a chat box on the right-hand side of the screen. If you have any question related to country or any question related to Duke travel, we have our team part of, we have team members joined in this session who can reply your questions. So if you have any questions related to this country or Duke International, so you just put your questions, it will be replied. So this is Church of All Saints. The monumental cathedral is a pride of the city, which stands at a height of 74 meters. It was constructed on the idea of a cross and a marquee, but today it has many domes. Each of these domes was built in honor of the saints in Belarus, dead people, children, and the soldiers who lost their life in the war, especially World War II. St. Peter and St. Paul Cathedral. It is the oldest Orthodox church in the city, constructed to keep monks who came from Vilna. Many of the monks settled here and began a church service daily. The church was closed in the 90s, but it was restored to the public as a church building in 1991. Our Cathedral, Holy Name of the Blessed Virgin Mary. It is one of the main shrines of Belarus and located in the city center near the famous town hall. It was built by another Jesuit member in the 17th century, but abolished and turned into Paris. Now we come to the beautiful nature parks. These parks are really huge in size. This is the image of Lohistky Park. Victoria Park. It's a very attractive park for most of the people visiting this. The park is also known as the Victoria Green Park and began with the Kosmolohsky Lake, began when the Kosmolohsky Lake was constructed. It was made to refine the surrounding areas of the city. It is one of the most beautiful parks in Minsk, adorned with colorful mountains, architectural structure, greenery, and many more. So if you just go through the image, so they have placed the planes used in World War II. There are so many water bodies, so many walking tracks. This is Minsk Botanical Garden. It's a very beautiful weekend. It's the most preferred weekend place. This garden is not just a scientific establishment, but it is also a place where you can go and relax at relaxed pace and quiet time. It was opened in 1932 and it's covered in pine forest. And today it has a wide variety of plant species. It's Elis Knights Park. It is a forest park which is exclusively made for kids, and it contains an amusement park and other attractions such as children's railroad, cinema, and few others. It is closely located to Minsk metro station and adjacent to the botanical garden. So you just have a look to the bottom four slides. So this park is very natural and very old. The kind of trees you can see, they are almost more than 60, 70 year old trees. So it's really beautiful. Minsk Sea. It's a reservoir actually, which is also known as to be the Minsk Sea, and it is the second artificial sea in Belarus. It was created in 1956 with many plans and aims such as sanitarium and stopped against the flash flood. So the activities which can be done in this lake is like you can go for sailing, you can go for swimming, you can go for rafting. Minsk Zoo. This is a rare and a unique museum in Minsk, which introduces over 400 species of exotic animals. There is also a natural pool which was formed from the Sevilok River, a playground and a showcase of three exhibitions. It was opened in 2015. And in 2016, the Dino Park was also added to this zoo. So you can see it's really beautiful place to come and watch the show, especially the dolphin shows. So very few places in the world you will get this kind of zoo where this kind of shows are being performed, and you get a chance to interact with these birds and animals by touching them also and taking pictures. This is Minsk Dolphinarium. The Dolphinarium organizes daily shows where you can swim with the dolphins, take photos with them, or even have a therapy course. It is a great place to be with the dolphins and a rehabilitation center for kids suffering from various disabilities. So nature has it all. Then this is another national park. It's a national park and a preserve, UNESCO World Heritage Site, and a home to a large number of bison. It is a very popular spot for hikers, cyclists, and favorite spot for the tourists. So bison is one of the most attractive animal here, the center of attraction. Then we can see some native jackals and the ostrich. So the three, four animals really attract a lot of people. If you get a chance to see them from a very close distance, it really gives you a good feeling. So bisons are known to be very wild buffaloes actually, and they weigh up to almost 300 to 400 kilometers. And they're very aggressive in nature. This is Grocki Park. It's a public park located near the Victory Square and established in 1800. The park is one of the oldest in the city and great place for children. It is now a recreational place for family, children, and has many other attractions and few monuments. Museums, the National Art Museum of the Republic of Belarus. It is one of the largest museums in the country and comprises of almost 30,000 works from various countries of the world. It features the artwork of artists of the 15th centuries of Western Europe and Asia. Today, the museum conducts scientific research and expanding its library holdings. This is another museum, Starna Mini. Basically, it is a museum which depicts the miniature. So whatever monuments and churches and buildings they have, it is the replica of those in a certain ratio. So basically it can be 70, it can be ratio of like 20 by 70. So something which has a height of 70 meter, you can see that same image in a height of say around 2 meters. So in that ratio, it has been demised, but it is exactly copy of those structures. So this museum exhibits over 21 miniatures and planning to create over 70 attractions in coming years. So you will see the display of the most significant and architectural landmarks of the country. In the museum, you will find souvenir shops, lounge area, and workshops, cafes. So this is a very good place and must visit when you are in this country. Belarusian Folk Museum of Architecture and Rural Life. The museum covers cultural region of Belarus in different periods. It is an open air museum which visitors come to enjoy the historical exhibitions of the past centuries. It is located on Menka River and it exhibits over 30 collection which include handwritten and printed material, literature and many others. Then we come to few brewery museums which this country has. Elveria is one of the oldest breweries in the country, which was founded in 1864. This is a museum for the beer, which is a part of the Elveria brewery. It provides details on the brewery history and beer. You can also examine the label bottles and wooden barrels. This is another major attraction for any kind of customer, whether they are like traveling with kids, without kids, or if they are traveling in a group. So this place is an excitement place for each and every age group people. So it's an aerospace museum. It is one of the kind museum which was founded in 2009, and there are many planes displayed in the open air. The museum has over 3 planes, helicopters, and constantly growing with the sample of 1916s and modern aviations. So whatever display you find here, you will feel like taking picture with each of these display, because every display has some story. They were all part of some of the war, so it's a different level of excitement altogether. Then we will just go through the options of shopping in the country. So it's another market, local market. It's Minsky Komarovsky Market. It's a local market where you can find a selection of meats, smoked food, fish, and dairy products, baker goods, which are all good in the taste and affordable in price. So you can see the image. You can find the rich vegetable, all kind of products in this market. So they have different areas for meat, different areas for bakery, the different areas for fruit, the different areas for dry fruits. So it's totally a very good layout, dome-shaped market. In most of the country, Central Asia or the Russian countries, you will find these kind of local markets, and they are really very good place for the people who grow these kind of vegetables and markets. Zamok Malls. It's a well-known shopping center, which is a bit farther from the city center. There is a wide selection of brands of all kind of eaters and affordable rate. It is more of hypermarket, which includes several beauty salon, cinemas, shop, food courts, and etc. The other market is ZUM. It is one of the oldest and the largest store department founded in 1951. It does not lag behind being a contemporary haven when you find the best shopping experience in Minsk. It has multiple floors and has several shops which are self-serving shopping. Its interior is adorned with old Soviet style of architecture, which shows at its best. This is another important underground mall, Stolitsa Underground Mall. It's almost like a modern mall with all the brand chains from those regions. Now we'll come to the detail of few good hotels. So we have listed some regularly used hotels, so, and the common names which we normally recommend to our groups. So starting from 5-star hotel, it's Minsk Marriott Hotel 5-star. Then we have DoubleTree by Hilton. So if you go through the images, they are really luxury in terms of the display. So fresh and all modern amenities displays you can find out. So if you have any group size, they can easily cater up to 300 people. Then we have DoubleTree by Hilton, Beijing Hotel. all these hotels have the all kind of facility of hosting any group, and along with the conferences. So it's easy to organize conferences and seminars in this country. So we have all kind of facilities to cater these needs. President Hotel. This is Renisa Min's Hotel. Now we come to some four-star hotels. This is Europe Hotel. Men's Hotel. Then Victoria Hotel. Boutique Hotel. Now we'll go through some details on the corporate places. It's ethno-cultural complex Nansoi. So if you see the images, this is really beautiful place where the local comes to host party during the weekends or during some festivals or celebration. Then pension. It's a wooden made structure for small groups. I think the size of 40 to 50 people, not more than that, because they are into the jungles. It's a very natural place. Events and banquets. Astoria Riverside. So they have all kind of facility. If you see the images, they have conference room. They have a huge reception area. They have all kind of meals displayed at a, like international level. This is Robinson Club. They have private yachts also. They have private swimming pools. This is Zare Shani. Basically, it's a place where wedding functions are performed. Just taking okay, I'm sorry, there was an important call. These are few restaurants. It's Kamenista restaurant, Bristow the Lakes. It's Kohimister. Grand Cafe. La Scala. Then we have casinos in this city. Casino Exo, Casino Sangrila. Casino Victoria Cherry. Then we have Opera Casino, Casino Royale. These are name of the few clubs in city. This is Druzia Restaurant Bar. Private house. So this was a little information about this country. So it's almost like any well-established European country. So if with all the facilities and amenities for all kind of travelers. Now we'll just have a small video about this country so that you can just have a aerial view of this country also and how beautiful this country is. Let's have a video play for a few minutes. It is a 4-minute video.
Okay, so this was about the country. Now we'll just move on to few important things. As I told you in the beginning, let's go back to the website dukeinternational.com. Another important thing which I would like to inform you is about the Agent Connect, which is a login for our B2B partners. So once you are approved, you can easily see all the departures, the fixed departures which we have uploaded live. So once the business resumes, we'll be again uploading with the website. So I will just take you through this. Like, you just need to use your email ID and password to log in. So if you are new, it has to be approved, and it will be approved by our back office within few hours. So you just need to put your email ID and your own password. So you will come on this page. So this is about the live updates on our all fixed departures. So I'm just clicking all these all destinations. If you see the names, so we have a guaranteed and fixed departures for Kazakhstan, Uzbekistan, Azerbaijan, Russia, and Kyrgyzstan. So few departures are once in a week. There are many countries which has like 3 to 4 departures every week. So you can just see, for example, I will just take you to this Uzbekistan. So once we click Uzbekistan, you come to on this page. So if you see, we had one departure which was scheduled for today. So total seats were 30. The bookings were, the seats available were 30. So it's a 4-night itinerary. You have option to view the itinerary. You have option to download the itinerary. You can send requests for a customized tour. You can see the optional tours and the different terms and conditions and the guaranteed price. So you just need to see this. You can see the details and you can inform your customers and collect the payment by taking an offline blocking. So you just need to do a time limit blocking and collect the money. So this Agent Connect is really, really helping a lot to many customers. And we have got a lot of appreciation on this. Now I will just take you back to our business development team, and I will request them one by one to introduce. Let me take you to the page where you can see their contact numbers and email IDs. Okay. So I request you all to just log into this website, dukeinternational.com. Now we are on the page of contact where I'm just sharing the list of the names and contact number of our team who are like completely dedicated to help you, help our travel partners to guide them about the Central Asia countries. In any kind of information, whether it is a booking or taking a query or some requesting for some meeting or some online guidance, anything. So I will just one by one, my teams will come and introduce themselves. So just allow me 1 minute. I will ask my colleague Abhishek to introduce himself first. Let me unmute him. So just allow me 1 minute. I'm just trying to connect with them. Okay, so my colleague, Shwetangi Tohan, she is the manager for this business development team. And most of the colleagues, you can see the names, I report to her only. So I request my colleague Swetangi to just introduce herself on this platform. Swetangi, can you hear
Hi.
Me?
Yes. Hi, everyone. I'm Swetangi from Duke Travels. I represent Business Development Pan India for Duke Travels. I've been associated with this company since last 7 years. And if you have any queries, you can write to us on sales@duketravels.com. We'll be happy to help you. Thank you,
Swetangi. Now I'll connect my colleague Rustic. Just a minute, Rustic. Let me unmute you. So Rustic, can you hear me now?
Yeah, hello, sir.
Yes. Just introduce yourself.
Yeah, hi, everyone. Good afternoon. Myself, Rashtik Chakravarti. I am based in Calcutta, looking after the eastern market of India, which is covered by Assam, West Bengal, Odisha, Bihar. Those are the states I am looking for. Whatever the queries you have, you can write to me. My mail ID is rashtik.chakravarti@duketravels.com. Thank you.
Thank you, Rashtik.
Thank you, sir.
So these are few colleagues. I will introduce a few more colleagues just be online. So now we have Madhu online from Chennai. So Madhu, can you hear me? Hello, Madhu, can you hear me? Hello. Okay, so I think Madhu might be on some other call. Let me see if I can connect to one of you more colleagues. Okay, so we have Mr. Hitesh from Ahmedabad. So he's basically focused on... Hitesh, can you hear me?
Can hear you clearly. Thank you.
Yeah, just please introduce yourself.
Yes. Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to the training. Say we are conducting since last 2 weeks. And welcome to the training. Myself, Hitesh Jani, taking care of total Gujarat and say some part of the Rajasthan also. And say I am with this company since last 10 months and hoping a great future with you all people, say healthy business and everything, and keep yourself very much safe, staying at home. Thank you so much, Chandan. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Hitesh. Thank you so much. So, these are a few colleagues, other colleagues. We'll try to connect them in some other session also. So, I request everybody to join the other sessions. Like we have sessions after half an hour, like from 1 to 2 o'clock, from 3 to 4 o'clock, and from 4 o'clock to 5 o'clock. So, we have sessions for Baku, for Russia, and for Almaty, and other places in Kazakhstan. So this was all about Belarus. So if you need some further information, you can always contact us through our business development team. So if you just need to go on the website, go into the contacts, and then you can see these things. Another important details I would like to share, like on the website dukeinternational.com. I know like most of the agents always send email to get the details. And again, the customer comes back with the changes. So 3-4 changes, it's a normal habit of any customer. So most of the time this happens because we are not ready with the details. So we just pass on the information what we have, and the customer starts exploring more and more, and they come back, no, this has to be there, this has to be this way. What we have done, we have just uploaded almost 60 to 70 itineraries, which you can easily download. So you just need to go on to the website dukeinternational.com and go to the departures, find the itinerary. So once you click the itinerary, you will just come on this page. So if you can see, we have the list of itineraries for fixed departure. We have a huge list of itineraries, recommended itineraries for FIT. So be it 3 nights, 4 nights, 5 nights, 6 nights, 7 nights, 8 nights, 9 nights, 1 country, 2 country, 3 country, 4 country. So this page is fully loaded with all the options of itinerary. So you can easily request your customer to not to do the changes and go for this itinerary, which will save your time also, and it will give a good impression to your customer that you are ready with their information and you recommended them the best itinerary. So it is always good. You just download these itineraries and you can share this with your customer also. So I'm just trying to open one itinerary. So this is one itinerary which you can just refer and you can download them. You can discuss this detail with your customers. So it is always good to have the details within minutes. So it is good that you are now equipped with all kind of itineraries related to Central Asia and few countries sharing the border with Central Asia. So thank you so much, everybody, for being part of this training. Thank you for your valuable time and the information. You can still put your questions in the chat column. We have so many questions which are being replied. So my team is there to reply the answers. So thank you so much, everybody. Please continue with your questions. We are there for another 5 to 7 minutes to reply your questions. Thank you again, everybody. Thank you so much. Thank you.